Today we will discuss in the third lecture the probability, which is the section 1.3, and the generalized statistical interpretation, which is section 1.4 in your book. Before going into the probability, let me revise a little bit again the statistical interpretation of quantum mechanics. The statistical interpretation of quantum mechanics. We call this is the Born approximation or the Born interpretation of statistical mechanics. You remember that we were having on this axis we were having x, and on this axis we were having psi mod square, and our distribution or the plot was like this, that goes here like this, and this was our point, which was A, this was our point B, and this region was small a, this was small b. Now, if I want to find out, because this is the probability density, to find out the particle, where the particle is, then I know that the particle is all this way except at point B, where its probability density is equal to zero. So some probability is here, some probability here and here. Here is the maximum probability and so on. So if I have selected this range, means from A to B, it will have some probability, like the integral from A to B in psi mod square dx will be equal to, means it will be not equal to zero. It will have some value. But I will have to start from here till here. Is this function, this is a function, and it is not ending. It ends at infinity, and it starts from minus infinity. So in order to normalize this thing, or to find out from minus infinity to plus infinity, then it will include all the probabilities, which is the statistical information. And psi mod square dx will be equal to 1. Means this will be, 1 will be the maximum probability. Now we will understand a little bit of the probability, that what is it, and what are the different terms which are used in understanding the probability. So let's start with section 1.3, which is the probability. So this is, let me start from here, 1.3, and this is probability. And we will take a very simple example, and then we will extend that example to our quantum mechanics. Let's say we are having the example of a classroom, such that in this classroom we are doing some distribution with respect to the number of students. On J I am plotting the number of years, and on N of J the number of students. How many students of a certain age are there? So let's say I start with some values. Let's say this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, 11, 12. In And let me extend this a little bit more in order to include more information. And this one goes another, and so on. Let me write that this is H10, this is 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and this is 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25, and 26. And this is J. Like, we are having age from 10 to 26. Now let's say we are having no one in this classroom who is having the age 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Let's say we are having only one which is having an age of 14. So this is one which is having an age of 14. And there is another one who is having age of 15, while we are having three persons who are having the age 16. Three persons having the age 16. Then no person here, and the age 22, we are having two persons. And then of 24, we are having two persons. So this is a very technical example in which we will elaborate many terms here. And then of the age 25, we are having five persons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And none of age 26, and so on. So this is our example. And here we will have to tell that N is giving you the number of students of a certain age, while G is the years, how many years are of there. So let's say, if I say how many of this are having the age 14, how many?
One.
How many are having age 16?
Three.
Let's say, don't forget to write 15 as well. 15. This is also one. Age 16, this is having 1, 2, 3. So we are having three of age 16. Then age 22. How many? 2. And age 24, we are also having 2. And age 25, we are having 5 students who are having the age 5. Rest, we don't have the students of that age. Now if I want to write the total number of people, the total number of students, the total number of students will be equal to N, and this N will be equal to, if I sum on J, and J starts from 0 to infinity, and I write NJ. Clear? So this will be N 0 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10. When it will reach N 14 will give you value 1. Then N 15 will give you value 1. N 16 will give you value 3. 1 + 1 + 3 + 2 + 5, and it will give me the total number of students, and this will be equal to 4 and 4 8 8 and 5 8 and 5 13, right? So we are having the total number of students is equal 13. Okay, now we will have this one is 3 4 5 5 plus 4 9 9 plus 5 14. So we are having a total of 14 students. Okay, now let's say I am finding the very first thing, which is 1 here, and this one is the probability of person of being a certain age. Probability of a student of a certain age. How I will find this probability? Let's say this will be probability, which I will denote by P, and this will be the certain age, and this will be equal to NJ, the number, divided by the total N. For example, if I want to write the probability of age 14, then NJ in 14 is equal to 1 divided by total N, 14. Clear? It will be 1 over 14. Similarly, the probability of age 15 is also 1 over 14. And the probability of age 16, how much? 16, 3 divided by 14. 3 by 14. Similarly, I can find the rest of them, but I know one thing, that if I sum all the probabilities on J, then this will be equal to 1. Because all the number 1 over 14 plus 1 over 14 plus 3 over 14 plus 2 over 14 plus 2 over 14 plus 5 over 14, and this will give you 14 by 14, and it will be equal to 1. So this will give you the total probability will be equal to, this is the maximum probability, which you call 100%, 100 by 100, and this is equal to 1. The next question that I'm dealing is, what is the most probable age? What is the most probable age? Here, if means the one which will have maximum probability, it will be the most probable age. Look here, that the maximum probability, this one is 1 over 14, 1 over 14, 3 over 14. 5 over 14 is having the maximum probability. So it means 5 over 14 is this age is the most probable age, and this age is 25. I can see from here, 25 age people are the most probable. Like in your class, this is your class distribution. So the most probable age in your class is actually 25. So the most probable age is 25. Okay. The third, what is the median age? What is meant by the median age? Median age means that same number will be less in age and same number will be more in age. Look here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are 9. Here are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. So 9 and 5 cannot be balanced. Look here. If I select this point, the number of people, the number of students from this point here and this point here are the same. Count them. 1, 2, 5, 6, 7. 7 here and 1, 2 and 5, 7. So from 23 age, 7 students are younger and 7 students are older. Right? So 23 age will be the median age. Mean the same number will be behind it and in front of it. So this we call the median age, and this age is actually 23. Now it's not necessary, because we do not have a person of this age. We don't have anyone, but this is actually the median age. The median age is actually the age from which the same number will be younger and the same number will be older, right? This we call the median. And this is just to differentiate between the median and the average. Now, let's say if I ask the fourth question, what is the average age? What about the average age? Now, the average age, I will represent age, represent I with J. Okay. I will represent this with J, and I can write this as like this. These are for the average, and J is actually the age. So this will be equal to summation on J. Now, is, I know that this is a summation on J, so it is, if I write J here, then it is understood that it is from 0 to infinity. And J times N J divided by N. J times N J by N. So, you know this thing, that what is N J by N? From here, N J by N is P of J. So it means this is summation on J, and this is J times P of J. Right? For N of J by N, I can write P of J. So it will be summation on this. Now look here, calculate this one, J, for our example. The very first one will be J, and J, the available one is 14, and then it is 1 over 14 is the PJ, because 1 over 14 is the PJ. Similarly, 15 and 1 over 15 plus 16, and this will be, what about P of J of 16, it is 3 by 14. Sorry, this one is